was really young, my grandmother had a medical book. Why she had it, I don't know, but it had pictures of, you know, muscles and arteries and things like that. And I used to always, whenever I got to Nan's house, I'd always go look for that book and just look at the pictures. So, and I guess sort of really be, you know, actually enrolling in a nursing school sort of really didn't, I didn't ever think I'd ever get to be a nurse. When I was in high school, the vocational officer, and I've actually got it written in my case file that I might be good enough to be a nurse's aide. I actually did try to get into nursing, which was at Geelong Hospital, and the matron took one look at me and said, "Oh no, oh no, she won't do. She's far too young, and besides, she hasn't got her matriculation." So I just decided then, oh well, it's really not going to be happening for me. So I just went off and worked and worked and worked. And when nursing went into universities or college trained, I sort of thought I might be able to enrol, but I didn't actually do it straight away. It took a long time to convince myself that I had half a brain and I'd be able to manage it. There were no other Indigenous students in the nursing course itself, and I just found everything just so hard. Nothing came easy. I seemed to be studying much more than the other students. When the holidays were on, I wasn't having a holiday. I was still studying. It was really difficult for me. Just understanding the language. I mean, the language that they use is just so not Aboriginal. It just didn't make any sense to me. So just learning that language first was probably harder than anything else. But once I sort of got that, it seemed to sort of fall into place. All things nursing, all things to do with health, and I don't know why, but anything to do with health always interests me. Becoming a midwife, after I finished my nursing degree, I vowed to myself I'd never study again because it was just so difficult. And then I decided that I'd do midwifery because that was one of the things that I wanted to do, because I wanted to get into remote nursing, and having a midwifery degree or certificate would be, you know, would help me. But becoming a midwife, which I absolutely love, it's one of the greatest things to do if you are a nurse. Couldn't even put it into words, really. You just get so much back from the women themselves, and the babies, I just love babies. And of course, you know, it is about the babies, just seeing the next generation of Aboriginal people, but just trying to give these babies the best start that they can possibly get, because it's still a struggle. So having healthy babies, and the more that we can bring into the world, the better. feedback that I've ever had with the women, and I've looked after non-Aboriginal women as well, because they've actually requested me. So all the feedback that I've ever had has always been fantastic. It's just made it, you know, really easy, because I'd do a lot of home visits instead of getting the women, you know, and they've usually got a few borais at home, you know, in the middle of winter, they've got to come in for an antenatal visit. They don't drive, or they haven't got a vehicle, or they haven't got any money. So I used to just say, don't worry about it. You know, I'll just call past, and I'd do their antenatal visit in their homes, and you get to know all the family. You get to know, you know, the circumstances of the family. If they need any help anywhere, you can refer them on. You know, you can put them in touch with a lot of services that are out there that they may not know. And just getting a better result health-wise. You know, like preeclampsia and gestational diabetes and all of those things that supposedly go with Aboriginal women in their pregnancies, providing, you know, a really good service. You don't seem to have those problems aren't as prevalent. Get a tutor or get somebody, you know, always put your hand up, always ask. You might think that, you know, people will look down on you because you ask, but you look at all the other students, they've got their hands up all the time asking. And when I was a student, I had a tutor for nearly every subject. So, you know, there are resources out there specifically for Aboriginal people. Use them. Don't wait until it's too late, or, you know, you're sort of bogged down, wait, asking for an extension. So, you know, ask. Always put your hand up. Without saying, it's that important. I mean, we need to have the opportunity to look after ourselves. We can't really do that yet because we don't have enough nurses and allied health people on the ground to be able to do it. So, you know, the more Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people we can get into the health profession, into allied, you know, the other allied services, using us as role models, is probably better than any advertising strategy that anyone can actually come up with. But I've always wanted to be a nurse, and I really think that nursing chose me, in a way. And sort of in some ways, I think sort of nursing sort of really sort of not saved my life, but, you know, sort of really has made, you know, has helped me make my life what it is now. And I really love it. I love it. It's the best job I've ever had.